The VTEC system in your Honda or Acura basically has two positions, open or closed. The solenoid stays closed at your usual RPM and gets open in the range of 4000 to 6000 RPM depending on the engine model and the year. When it opens, it sends the oil through a different path and activates a different valve time and scenario for better power output. When the RPM level drops below 4000, the solenoid should close and revert the oil flow to its initial state to bring the valve time into the most fuel efficient position. This is probably too simply explained, but I just want to make this video short and easy to understand. So the VTEC solenoid may get stuck open or closed, and if it's stuck closed, you will probably not feel this since most drivers will almost never go over 4500 RPM. Of course, this will affect your high RPM performance, so if you're driving professionally, you will have problems. But if the solenoid is stuck open and lets the valve timing be in the performance position at low RPM, this creates a number of problems. The most common symptoms of such a problem are unstable idling and stalling when at idle, low power output, check engine light, and a range of VTEC related codes in the ECU, like the P2647, for example, VSA light, emission system warnings, unusual sounds from the VTEC valve, and 15 to 20% worse gas mileage than usual. Well, the majority of Honda owners will just buy a new VTEC assembly that costs $200 to $400 depending on the type and model year. It's often enough to just clean it. The VTEC system suffers from contaminated or low quality oil since it has tiny oil patches and valves, and simply cleaning with the gasoline or carb cleaner will do the trick unless the solenoid is broken. If you decide to opt for cleaning, don't forget to get the new VTEC assembly gasket that is fairly cheap but will cause oil leaks unless replaced before installation. Also, for proper operation, the VTEC system needs a good engine oil level and proper oil viscosity. If the level is over the maximum mark on your dipstick, pump out some oil since it creates high pressure in the system. If there is not enough oil, the pressure will not be sufficient for the VTEC solenoid to operate properly.